Hi, I'm Vanessa. I'm the mom of My Kids Really Eat This, and today I wanted to show you what to do with Swiss chard, fresh out of our bin from our shared harvest, or CSA, and we have really, really gorgeous, beautiful colors here. This is just vibrant, green, large, healthy, and quite stiff. Because it was just cut earlier today and brought home. So there is no refrigeration, no transportation except from the farm to the house. I'm going to take it and do one of the simplest preparations for it. I'm steaming it, I'm going to shock it, and then reheat it with a little butter, salt, pepper. And this is the way that my kids really eat Swiss chard, because it doesn't change the flavor of it. They've gotten used to what it tastes like, which is very earthy, almost metallic at times, but very fresh and with a little bit of salt and butter, very pleasing to the palate. I've got my water ready. It started to boil. I've got a steamer on top, and I'm just going to cut it into pieces. So. First, I take the very bottom, I put it all together so they're even, and I just take that first cut from the farm and put it in the compost. So I'm going to just cut this into about 1-inch strips, taking all the leaves together. And this is the way I cut romaine lettuce as well when I'm making a simple salad. This might be a bit larger than I would use for a salad, but kale I would do similarly. And we have some kale here. The only difference with kale and the chard, we eat the stems on the chard. It's too tough on the kale, so you would just strip it off and then cut. Okay, you want to pause? We cut Swiss chard, and I'm just going to rinse it off. It can have, because it is grown in a garden without pesticides, there can be some things in there that we don't necessarily want to eat, but are not bad for you. It's just not appealing. And also, that includes dirt. But this has not been washed. It's been directly cut from the stem at the farm. This is a bit small for this one. We just put all of this Swiss chard, and this is called rainbow chard, this variety.
Your cat is named.
That's right. Our cat's named Rainbow. This type of Swiss chard has all the different colors. My kids love rainbow chard because of the vibrant colors. And one of the things that you want to remember when you're cooking vegetables of any kind, when you're cooking, is not to overcook. Because when you take away that color, it can make the vegetable look sort of an unappealing brownish, greenish that kids don't like the color of. Nor do they like the taste as much, because you've taken away not only nutrients but taste. Altered it as much more so that it's less appealing, less fresh. This is much healthier. We are just going to steam this now. 3 minutes, that's it. And then I'm going to throw it, because I'm not cooking, I'm not doing the rest of my meal, you can just rest it, test the ends. If it's still really hot, you shock it with cold water. So we're going to wait for that to steam and then see what we need to do. Okay, so this Swiss chard looks ready. It is still vibrant, colorful. It's still got the beautiful red and green, and I'm going to bring it over to the sink. And I'm actually going to shock this one because of I'm eating a piece of the stem. Not everybody likes them, but my youngest one likes the stems the most because he finds the texture appealing, the taste appealing, but also that little bit of crunch that's retained when you don't overcook. that's it for me right now, Vanessa, mom of My Kids Really Eat This. I hope your kids will eat it too.